For the longest weeks, to days, to hours, I've been hearing so much about Attack on Titan and how this season's finale will be the most sad but greatest series due to us finally understanding the story, but also how a beloved character gets hurt, which changes the views on how people feel about another. It was sad to see Sasha go and hear that her last words were meat, as all she wanted to do was raise cows and sheep so she could eat as much as she wanted. But then Gabby had to go and end that possible future she had decided to chase as a girl. Finally, I understand why the community of manga and Attack on Titan fans despise the character. She is an influenced child of the views Marley has placed on the children of Eldians to have against those outside of her city. And although Eldians themselves, she was brought up to see them as the enemy. Not only that though, I think what makes Gabby hated much more is the extra mile she went to get on the airship and take that shot, but also the fact that we really do not know her as well as we did Sasha, the potato-loving girl. In total, the Survey Corps lost 6 people in the retaliation of Paradise Island once being destroyed by Titans, but also now it counts for 7 as Sasha has also fallen. What is going on, guys? It's your boy Roos, and welcome to the channel. If you are new here, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe as it helps my channel out a lot. I think we all knew that Reiner didn't have it in him to last and even decide to fight against Eren, as just a moment ago he was down bad and was about to give up on his whole being if it weren't for Falco and Gabby screaming at the top of their lungs to get him to react. It worked though, because he stood up and prioritized saving Porco instead of fist fighting it out with Eren, which in one way had worked, but also took significant damage to the jaw of his own, showing that it had been destroyed. There are three or maybe two things that really kind of just said hi, hello to me, and those things were finding out that Zeke had planned out this ordeal, obviously along with Levi and Hange, which was just a doozy, as this man betrayed his own family. Peek remembering and showing us the soldier who she once encountered about 3 years ago, who was involved in the missing first survey fleet that was sent to Paradise Island and is a follower of Zeke's. And lastly, the cycle of war between Eldians versus Eldians, because really, I don't hear no other race in this series fighting one another so extensively due to manipulation. I'll start off first with the Eldians in the internment zone, who are the main sacrifices when sent out to war. I feel personally as though we got the understanding of why the races were separated within different sides of the world, but we didn't get the full story on how Titans became 9 and why holders of such powerful destinies are labeled to fight one another and have so much hate towards each other. They are literally from the same bloodline, so if Marley has something to do with it, as well as their inclusion of manipulation through teachings and stories, I'd like to know. What key factor are we missing to understand the power struggle for the Titans all in one place? That is something I'm interested in knowing, and I'm sure they'll probably let us know down the line of the origins of the Eldians' history. The other is Zeke and his follower being a part of the missing first survey fleet, as well as Zeke helping to plan this all out. Was he responsible for them missing? And what sense or selfish goal does he have working with the demons of Paradise Island? Why plan this out? It's like the more I find myself understanding part of the story of Attack on Titan, another pops up with multiple questions that need answering, leaving me wanting to know more. Why this? Why that? Do people already from the first survey fleet not like Marley and agree with their ways? Are they on the verge of betraying them? Zeke seems to be the mastermind behind this, but Zeke himself comes off as really shady. And would it make sense to trust someone who was even able to betray their own mother and father? I don't think so. The Survey Corps would be stupid to do so. I guess that's why they have their eyes on him, especially Levi. It seems to me that those who know the truth, like Falco, Eren, Armin, and even Reiner, to an extent, know that the fighting is semi-pointless and does nothing for each other. But because both nation and other nations are interested in the powers of Titans, they know that fighting is the only way they'll be able to protect one's home from its dangers. A sad loss in episode 8 of Attack on Titan's most beloved character in this series. And I'm sure the community will never forget this headliner. But damn, what an episode changer. An anime episode or series really hits when something is tragic or greatly amazing, but also when a community has been built around it largely. Rest in peace, Meat, Potato Girl, Sasha, a great addition to this series. It's been your boy Roos, or Mr. 36, and whether you're watching or listening to this in the morning, afternoon, or evening, I hope you guys have a good day. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and make sure to follow the podcast especially. I'm out. Peace.
俺たちはまた生き残った。他の仲間には悪いけど、やっぱりお前らは特別だよ。